Hey guys, this is Brent with Western Equipment, and I'm about to do a test to see just how fast we can heat up our studio barn. We're out here in Western Oklahoma. We've had about 10 solid days of below freezing temperatures, some of those below zero temperatures. So I'll go ahead and just hop outside here, show you what this looks like. This is not typical Oklahoma weather. So yeah, you can see all that snow there. Nice and cold. We're sitting right around 20 degrees today. We've made some changes out here. We've gotten us a John Deere AC190 space heater. So these space heaters push out 190,000 BTUs. Now, as you can see around me here, this is a foam insulated barn. Probably about 1-inch foam insulation. It's a 35 by 50. So we're looking at 1,750 square feet. We do have the big opening doors there on one end. And as you can see, guys, not a tightly sealed barn. We've also got the one walkthrough. So, I mean, there's some draftiness to this barn, but this is where we do all the work, all the videos that you guys see. So today we're gonna put our heater there to the test, see what we can do, see how fast we can get this barn heated up. So if you'll stick with me here, we'll get started. So to start, guys, I want to show you, we've got a thermometer set up here. As you can see, our inside temperature is reading LLL. So obviously it's going to be below freezing inside here. And then also you can see down there in the corner, it's going to be showing 24 degrees. From what the weather says, what my phone says, it's actually around 12 to 13 degrees outside. But we're not really worried about that. We're worried about inside the barn here. So we're just going to see how quick we can get those numbers up out of freezing and see what temperature we can get to. So here on the space heater, like I said, John Deere AC190. So what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and crank the temperature up to 80. We're going to run this thing for 15 minutes. I'll set a timer on my phone. We'll see how warm we can get the barn in 15 minutes. So I've got it filled up here with kerosene. We've got it set to 80. I'll go ahead here, flip the switch, and then go start the timer and see what we can do. Alright guys, so after 15 minutes, I'm going to show you what our heater reads. Now keep in mind, we've got the heater here in the center of the shop, and it does have a thermometer on it. That way it's taking that reading as it's putting it out. That way it can shut off whenever it gets to that heat. But what you have to keep in mind is all the heat is being produced right here in the center at the heater. So it's going to read true temperature around the air in its space. Now, like I said, this barn's 1,750 square feet. So, you know, we've got a lot of corner space. We've got those drafts. We've got different spots in here. So the temperature, it's going to have to spread out. And also, if you look up here, we don't have any ceiling fans that are pushing that heat down. So that heat is rising up. And so it's gonna be a little inconsistent on where it's heating at. So we've set our thermometer all the way over here on the back side. And as you can see, now we're not sure exactly what the reading was before. We just know it was low, low, low by the three L's. So it was definitely below 32. So we've at least raised it by 16 degrees. We're almost there at 48. Now the reading at the unit, now when we had it set on 80 degrees, the reading at the unit is showing 66. And I can tell you that from walking from here to the center to the edges of the barn, there's definitely a temperature difference. So what I think we're going to go ahead and do is I'm going to kick that back on and see just how long it takes to get up to that 80 or up to where it'll kick off. So I'm going to set the timer for another 10 minutes, put the camera here back on the stand, and let's see just how much we can raise that temperature in the far corner of the barn with 10 more minutes of running this unit. Let me turn it back on here for just a second. So the reading we have here is at 66. Now the reason why I want to show you that right whenever you turn the unit off is because the most accurate temperature you're going to get here at the unit is while it's still running, and that's because there's a fan in this unit that's pulling in the cooler air going through the burner and then forcing that warm air out the front. So once you turn these units off, or if you dial this down to kick off the heat, this temperature is actually going to continue to rise as the heat within the machine is going to raise the temperature here on the gauge, which isn't going to be completely accurate to what your temperature is in the space around you. So right when we turned it off, we were showing 66. And if we move over here to our thermometer that's set up over here on the far end of the barn, we're reading 61.5. But the main thing that we wanted to see here, guys, is that within 25 minutes, we were able to raise the temperature of this barn at least 30 degrees. Like I said, we couldn't see the actual reading inside because on these thermometers, whenever you have them set to read inside temperature, when you get below 32 degrees, they're gonna read low because they're thinking this is in your house and they want you to know, hey, dummy, turn the heater on, it's cold in here. So we can at least know that we raised from 32 up to 62 in 25 minutes. So we had a 30 degree change in 30 minutes. Now keep in mind, like I said, 35 by 50, we have 1750 square feet that we just heated up 30 degrees in 25 minutes. So you're moving that up more than 1 degree per minute. Very impressive for one of these units. Just to show you the power of one of these John Deere space heaters is what we want to get out of this video today. So I hope that you were able to see that. I hope maybe that you were able to see something that, hey, this may be something that'll work for my operation. Maybe this is something I need to look into to heat my barn that I'm working in. So guys, if this is something that you think that you may need for your operation, I'm gonna leave a link in the description below where you can go to check these out, where you can get one of these from me directly. Also guys, just keep in mind there's other sizes of this. Maybe you have that larger barn, you know, you have a different area that you're thinking about heating. They do have other sizes, 215,000 BTUs moving up, down. You can go to 135,000 BTUs, and we have a unit lower. And also for those smaller purposes, we also have these propane heater 18,000 BTUs. So I'll also leave a link in the description below to this one as well, so you can check those out. But guys, mainly I hope this video helped you out. I hope that you were able to see what you can do with one of these space heaters. If you like this video, we just ask that you'd please give us a like and a subscribe, as that helps us out as well. Also guys, check out that link in the description below for any other John Deere parts needs, whether it be for your mowers, gators, tractors, whatever those needs may be, make sure to check that out. Also guys, if you feel like I left anything out, you have any other questions or comments, make sure to leave those for me in the comments section below, as I do make sure to get back to you guys. And also guys, as always, thanks for watching. We'll see you next time. Hey guys, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and go buy your parts at west-equip.com/parts.